Hello, I'm Kamla. Welcome to a show where we bring you conversations and interviews with entrepreneurs, technologists, filmmakers, and other newsmakers from in and around the San Francisco Bay Area. My guests today are Academy Award winners Nat Faxon and Jim Rash. They wrote and directed Way, Way Back, their new film that releases on July 5th. They won their Oscar for writing the screenplay with Alexander Payne for The Descendents.
Duncan, on a scale of 1 to 10, what do you think you are?
A 6.
I think you're a 3. Since I've been dating your mom, I don't see you putting yourself out there, bud. You can try to get that score up at my beach house this summer.
This and all his awkward glory.
This is my son, Duncan.
I was going to name my youngest Duncan, but we went with Peter. Finally. Fixed his lazy eye, now it's even worse.
Boop, boop. Mom.
Just stare at the bridge of his nose, that's what I do.
You're the worst parent.
There's a message in the skies and in the streets.
Heads up, buddy. You need to wear that.
Mom, why do I have to wear this? Nobody else does.
Superstar. Sexy.
Congratulations on your new movie, The Way, Way Back.
Thank you very much.
Debut.
Yeah.
Yes.
What was it like being behind the camera? For a feature film.
Yeah. Stressful, you know, I think in a nutshell. It was a great experience, you know, but I think as writing partners, we sort of, you know, we knew this story so well. We've been with it for 8 years. And so to be able to have the opportunity to sort of see the whole vision and do the whole thing ourselves, I think was one of the great experiences, I would imagine, so far in our career.
Who came up with the title, The Way, Way Back?
Who should we get credit? Yeah, do we want to say
like
at the same time?
Turn.
All right, mine.
Mine.
Oh, okay. The Way, Way Back, I think we both understood it because it pertains to the back seat of those old station wagons, and we both had families who would have them. So we would we'd ride in that ill-conceived Way, Way Back where traffic is facing you and coming at you.
But the original title was The Way Back.
It was, yeah. Yes, which was... I think
some people call it the
Way Back. Some people call it the Way, Way Back. It worked for, both worked. There was another movie that came out called The Way Back, so we had to add our way.
Yeah, we didn't want people to think we were a sequel to a more movie.
So National Lampoon.
Hmm?
I'm thinking of National Lampoon, you know, when you talk about The Way Back and traveling in a wagon and everything.
Oh, yes, vacation.
Yes, vacations.
And so this is a movie based on your combined... repository of growing up,
yeah.
You know, and both of you in some ways are from the East Coast. You're from the South and you're from Massachusetts.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And water parks.
Yeah.
What is the deal with the water parks growing up and summers and, mm-hmm. you know, coming of age stories? And I'm thinking Meatballs, I'm thinking John yeah. Hughes.
Yeah. Yes. No, I think we just had a mutual real love for water parks.
Just, yeah, a good love. You know, because I think they were like this... fondness, because you sort of got like dropped off, at least during our days. Mm-hmm. You just got dropped off, maybe a little money in your hand, and it was sort of, there was an independence. I mean, half the people that work at these places and are sort of running the slides are maybe 2 years your senior, you know, and it was just like a place that we felt like you find eclectic, interesting characters, and it felt like the perfect place to set sort of an Oz for our lead character.
So this was part of your childhood then?
I think going to them, you know, the movie was inspired a little bit about that. You know, certainly destination vacations is something that we're both familiar with, and people congregating year after year at a similar location, that was a huge thing for us. And finally, you know, the first scene of the movie where Trent's asking if Duncan is on a scale from 1 to 10 what he thinks he is, that's verbatim from an experience that I had growing up at 14 when my stepfather asked me that exact same question when we would drive up to Michigan, and we were in a station wagon, the whole scene. So that was our sort of rip from the headlines of my pain.
So then
we added everything else.
So that's a sentence that stayed with you all these years.
Oh yeah, yeah. I remember the conversation vividly. Yes.
Did you ever go back and talk to him about that?
No, you know, that was a chapter, like, you know, high school in the 14 through, you know, mid college, you know, it was just, I never really confronted him about it or anything, but it definitely stuck with me, you know. I understood the message. And now we obviously amped up the role of Trent and sort of heightened it for the purposes of a movie. It's not him. I'm not saying that it's an exact replica of him, but I also understood the message, much like Duncan sort of inadvertently adheres to what Trent says.
And what about your input into the movie, into the writing of the script?
I really had nothing to do with it. I was just happy to be a part of it. I think we certainly drew upon our experiences, like Jim said, with the water park and with having a sort of, I think everybody can identify and relate to a rite of passage moment in their lives, you know, looking back a summer that maybe defined them more so than others. And certainly I had an older cousin that was similar to Owen and you know, brought me along. But I think, you know, we pulled from personal experiences, we pull from, you know, character development. Certainly, you know, Alison Janney's whole first monologue really,
which ran into 5 pages.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yes, came from, you know, those Christmas cards, those Xeroxed Christmas letters that you get from families that sort of inform you what's happened the entire year. And we had a good friend that got a very negative one that was telling about all the horrible things that had happened. So we just sort of pull from, you know, experiences and character, yeah, and, you know, all sorts of things.
Can you talk a little bit about the impact of John Hughes on you all growing up, because he's the gentleman who made Breakfast Club and Home Alone, as well as Ferris Bueller?
I think the idea that we were sort of inspired, when people ask us, you know, who, what this movie feels like, we always wanted a sense of nostalgia, so our brain would sort of go to the idea of what John Hughes could do with balancing comedy and drama, but specifically with dealing with very dramatic moments for, you know, his teen characters or young adults, and never speak down to them and allow that to never hinder the comedy, but at the same time really sort of give it more depth. And I think that we have respect for that and wanted to have something that felt nostalgic. Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. You're having way too much fun. It's making everyone uncomfortable.
Wow! I'm just kidding. That wasn't even my best stuff. Come on.
Just hold there for a sec.
As an artist, watch and learn.
And you are holding? Still holding? Just about ready to hold.
You think it's over now?
I need you to reorder more mats.
Did it?
Finish the work schedule for next week.
Did it?
So you know I'm gonna check all that stuff, right?
Oh, well, in that case, I didn't do any of that.
How do you make more money than I do?
That's the one you wait for, my man. I need someone to do some odd jobs, clean up some vomit.
Definitely.
Does your mom know you work here?
Who's that big guy?
Is this a girl?
What are you doing over here talking to us?
Well, maybe, Roddy, if you guys hadn't called me over here.
Please let your lady friend know that this conversation was entirely about her.
Where have you been?
Nowhere.
It's a long time to be nowhere.
Well, that's where I was.
Duncan, if we were going to make this work, then there has to be trust.
Oh, boyfriend called me a 3. Who says that to somebody?
That's about him. It's got nothing to do with you.
How do you know?
Because I know. You gotta go your own way. And you, my friend, are going your own way.
This is the only place I'm happy.
My doctor said not to get water on my face!
Hold there.